Greetings everyone and welcome back to Let's Build episode 7. In this episode I'm going to do a tiny little bit of the inside and then I'm going to go around and do all the grounds around the train station. What you can see that I'm doing here is I'm going around and I'm getting rid of all of the white frames around all of the windows at the bottom because it really wasn't working from a design point of view, so I wanted to get rid of those and put something very basic, which was just a quartz panel at the bottom of the window. Next up, I'm going around and doing the very basic task of just changing all of the floors to a different texture and then going and doing all the second floor. So in this case, I'm putting concrete on the bottom floor because it's a very nice texture. It goes with the outside, it flows through to the inside, and I can change it later. It's just so I can get a good idea of what's going on. This second floor is actually made with just a slab block. It's so I can have a different texture on the floor compared to the ceiling of the floor below. And then I'm going around and I'm just adding a ceiling block. I'm not sure about these textures. Again, I could always change this later on. It's so we can get a basic idea of what's going on. Here you can see the slabs underneath, so we can have a different texture on the top of the block to the bottom of the block, meaning we can have a ceiling on one side and a floor on the other, which is very handy. It's a very great design technique when you're working with limited space. And then again, you can see what I did with those bricks around there was so I could see brick through the glass and then having the wood around it. So now we're moving on to the outside. That was a very basic inside thing that we're doing there. We're going to go back to that in another episode. Now moving on to the outside of the build, I am now building a wall all the way around. Well, only on three sides, because the fourth side, I don't know how big this whole area is going to be yet, so I'm only doing the three sides. And I figure out a decent gap, which I use as four, then a pillar, four, then a pillar. And even after figuring out those sizes, I still had to go back and change where the train station actually was to get it to line up with the wall. But before I do that, I have to set everything up in MC Edit because I want to build a massive car park. So here you can see I'm just adding in the detail of the entrance to the car park and doing some of the wall design where I make it slightly thicker. It's just an extra design thing. It's a small detail, but it really adds a lot. And then from there, I did a lot of stuff in MC Edit because this was a huge thing that I tried to build. And it was just so long, especially doing those lines. Because those lines are only part of the block, having to do all of those and then all the stuff that fits in between them is really time consuming. So that was the only bit that I skipped, and I don't like doing that in a Let's Build video, but it really required it. So moving on from the car park, we go on to the gardens. This is just what I wanted to do here was to flow the car park through to the train station, but I wanted to just have some nice greenery, just a nice area to walk through in between. So I add a little path in the middle here. I've also got a small path running along the fence, which is just it's just a small bit of path. And then all I do is I add some tall grass. I'm going to go back later perhaps and change that design. One thing that I realized when I did this, I knew that it needed a garden, but I'd never really made a garden before, and it's not really something I know much of in Minecraft. So this was definitely a trial run for me. I've never done this sort of thing before, and I guess it was just a learning curve. I'm going to get used to perhaps doing these gardening designs, but as I get better, I'm sure I can go back and redo the things that I don't think are that great. And if you have any ideas of how I could improve the garden, please let me know in the comment section below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Maybe I can go back and then change it based on what you've said. So now moving on to the little gardeny area. This is the first time I've ever done something like this. I used angled paths. Normally, I just use straight stuff, and it's because of the whole Minecraft blocks thing, and I'd never really done this before. I wasn't sure how it was going to work with the micro blocks as well, because I go around and I use the same path design here, where I actually have the curb lip around, and it didn't turn out that bad, I don't think. You'll have to let me know how you think in the comment section below, but I really don't think it turned out that bad, but I still didn't know what to put in it exactly. So as you can see, what I just did there is I'm adding in all the fencing around, and the reason for that is because I want to separate this garden area from the train tracks, which are going to be right at the front of the screen here. So you can see that I make a massive train track. I actually go back. I found that this was just way, way, way too big. So you can see that I actually shortened down the wall there. I'll be worrying about that in maybe two episodes' time, because next episode I want to get the interior done, and then we'll be moving on to the train tracks, train platform, and all that sort of stuff. So you can see I used the same tall grass around the edges, then I went around with some bone meal, filled in the middle, and some of those meant that plants and trees grew, and some of the trees I didn't exactly want. Some of the trees I wanted to grow didn't actually grow, which was very strange. So here you can see I'm fitting in this wall, and the measurements don't exactly match, so I try and deal with that as best I can. But there we go, that is all of that there. And the reason for that change is being different from the other side is because of the car park being in the way. You can see the entrance to the car park again. I didn't use straight, I actually used a bit of curvature, as much as I can with the limitations of Minecraft. I also have some road signs right at the bottom. You can see there with that piece of iron with the signs, that are, they are literally road signs. I think that one was an entrance sign, and then the ones on the corner are the road signs. And it's just another detail that I'm obviously going to go and do more of when I do the builds in the future. But this is where we got to so far. You can see these walls, you can see the 3D-ness of the sticking out more. I used two different fence designs. One of them is a basic design on the bottom, and then the top is the sort of top of the design. They are part of the chisels mod, and they are supposed to go as a pair, which is great. And I think they work really well as a nice and it's a tasteful fence. And it doesn't make it look like some sort of scary place that you're supposed to be locked out of. Because obviously this is where there's a garden around the outside. But you can see the fencing that's blocking off between the garden and the train tracks is I do use a barbed wire texture, and I think that fits it as well, because obviously you're still going to have the barbed wire for people's safety and all that sort of thing. I don't know what I'm going to be doing with that train track and platform yet. I'm going to be thinking about how I'm going to be doing the design, but again, as I said, in the next episode I'm going to be covering doing the interior. I don't know if that's going to spill over into two episodes. Hopefully it won't, because I want to put in a lot of details, and hopefully that won't take up too much time. And then I will be using Traincraft and Railcraft and all that stuff, hopefully, and making the platform, which is super exciting. And then that will actually be the end of this build, and I'll be moving on to something else. And I don't know what I'm going to be doing yet, but probably do a couple of smaller builds to make up for this big, long, multi-episode thing. So there we go, guys, that is it for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting, subscribing, and sharing it with all of your friends. Now, I've had some of you comment that said that you wish that I had posted this more frequently. The reason I don't post it more frequently is because it's so time-consuming doing one of these. The recording time for this was about 5 or 6 hours in this episode, which is pretty crazy. Not including the time that I did all the MC edit work for the car park. It was a really time-consuming episode, this one. To make up for that, I have some series that I'm trying to plan, which I should be able to have more frequent uploads of. Hopefully you guys will enjoy those things. But there we go, that's it. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye!